Hello students, this is Monami Mukherjee and today I'm going to discuss with you a very famous poem by Rabindranath Tagore, Where the Mind is Without Fear. I will explain to you this poem and also give you an analysis of different aspects of this poem. So stay with me till the end of this video and do not forget to subscribe if you haven't done so yet. Where the mind is without fear, which is also known as Chitto Jetha Bhoy Shunno in Bengali, is the 35th poem of Rabindranath Tagore's book Gitanjali, for which he won the Nobel Prize. It's considered to be one of the most loved of Tagore's patriotic poems, and it talks about not just the ideal kind of India which Tagore hoped for, but also his concept of nation and nationalism. The whole poem is structured as a series of clauses. He is talking about an ideal country, a beautiful place where everything happens in the correct way. And as we go through these clauses one by one, we will see how they apply to our modern times as well. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. When Tagore was writing this poem, India was still under the colonial rule of the British government. So of course, Indians were not free at all. But he is not just talking about the freedom of the body, he is also talking about the freedom of the mind. So no matter whether your country is under a foreign rule or not, you might or might not have the kind of freedom of mind that Tagore is talking about. Now I will read this poem in this way, where we are going to analyze not just Tagore's context, what happened during his time, but also what is happening in our times. So when we talk about freedom of mind, I want you to think about nations where the rulers, they do not allow the citizens to think freely, to make any statements freely. Now if you think you also live in a country like that, then your mind is not yet free. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. Now when somebody's mind is fearless, when somebody is not scared by any authority, then they do not have to stoop down or bend low in front of someone, and they can hold their head high like a proud person. Where knowledge is free. Now in an ideal nation, a person can acquire knowledge as much as he wants. But in reality, we find that knowledge is something which always demands a price. Not always monetary price. Yes, you have to pay to get educated. But also, you need to invest a lot of time. So knowledge, although it might sound very nice if you say that knowledge is free, knowledge is not really free. Where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Now, what are these narrow domestic walls? The domestic walls means the boundaries which break up a nation. Boundaries of caste, class, religion, things which make Indians away from each other. That stops them from feeling united. So here, Tagore is very prophetic in thinking that his nation is not perfect because the Indians always try to build walls around themselves, which are narrow and domestic, which does not allow them to become a global citizen, a united citizen, where words come out from the depth of truth. So when you are not scared, when you have free knowledge, and when you are not bound by these restrictions, these superstitions, then you speak the truth. Why does a person need to lie? A person lies when he is scared of something. So if you take away that fear from the mind, then that proud man will not lie. So see, all these clauses are so very connected. Where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. So in that ideal world, in that good India, people would strive, would struggle to become better citizens, and they would be perfect people, whatever their professions be. If they are fearless, if they are allowed to speak their mind, if they can gather enough knowledge, they can become perfect. Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. So he is comparing dead habit to a desert. What is dead habit? Dead habit is the kind of things which we are used to do out of habit without questioning. They include superstitions. They include religious practices which we follow blindly. They include our racist ideas, where we look at a person and judge him because of his birth. So these are the dead habits which do not allow us to become better than what we are. And this kind of action is completely against logic or reason. So reason or logic is like a clear stream. When you have a fearless mind and knowledge, you can think in a logical way clearly, and your mind will not get dried up into that desert of dead habit. Where the mind is led forward by thee. Now, who is thee? Thee is an archaic form of you. So here, because Tagore is praying to God, so here you refers to God. And he says that the mind is led forward by thee. Now, you might say that in the previous sentences, he's talking about a logical mind, clear stream of reason. Then why is he talking about God here? This God is not any one God in particular, but the idea of nation, the idea of leadership, which he is appealing to, that India should be led fearlessly into a perfect land, into ever widening thought and action. So he was always interested in not just thought, but how that thought is connected to action. That is what a true leader does. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. So he is directly addressing this divine figure as his father, because that is what a Hindu prayer sounds like. You address gods as fathers and mothers. So he is addressing to this father figure of divinity so that his nation can become all of this. So this is basically a very simple poem, but it has very important elements in it which are still very relevant. For your exams, you might be asked questions like, what is the meaning of clear stream of reason? What is the meaning of dead habit? But this poem is beyond that. This poem is not just for your exams. This poem is for trying to understand what your position is. Has India truly become what Tagore had hoped for? Tagore in his time might have thought that the end of this colonial rule will create the space for freedom. But sadly, none of these things have happened. We haven't got out of our dead habits. We have only built more walls around us. Walls of religion, walls of caste. Knowledge is the most expensive thing in our nation today. Even when you are watching this video thinking that it's absolutely free, think about the internet which you need to spend to watch this. So nothing is free, neither your mind nor the knowledge which you think you're gaining. So the only way to acquire this freedom is to have faith that the clear stream of reason, the logic which he prays for, will save us from turning into desert animals. This poem is otherwise a very simple poem, and I will provide you with important questions and especially the solutions which you look for all the time in a PDF. You will get it right here along with the video. I will try to make another video in Bengali if you have difficulty in following English. But again, I would advise you to watch this video along with the Bengali version. So I hope this class was useful to you, and I will be taking up other texts in your compulsory English syllabus soon. So stay subscribed and have a very nice day. Bye-bye.